Everybody has an agenda in the tag team match on today's SICW Wrestling Explosion. Hello, I'm Larry Matisick. Ricky Cruz and Chris Hargis face Flash Flanagan and Ron Powers. The agenda? All four want a shot at the Classic Wrestling Championship. In addition, there are enough feuds, bad feelings, and big egos involving these four that anything could happen today. This also describes our classic St. Louis memory, a battle between Dick Murdoch and Kevin Von Erich. Have your seatbelts fastened after these messages. Baseball season is here and the Gateway Grizzlies are in action. Hardworking, hustling on every play, and lots of fun. What better way to spend an evening than at the gorgeous GCS Stadium watching the Grizzlies? Manager Phil Warren has a solid squad as they battle to make the playoffs. Special nights, plenty of promotions, and good baseball. Plus, GCS Stadium is easy to reach at Route 255 and Moosette Lane. To keep up with everything, go to gatewaygrizzlies.com. It's America's game, and the Grizzlies present baseball the way it should be.
Unique and affordable gifts and collectibles on the internet are available at the Black Bear Haversack Trading Post. Go to blackbearhaversack.com. Semi-precious stones, bone horn and soapstone items, abalone shells, genuine coyote and water buffalo teeth pendants, products for Civil War, medieval, and Renaissance reenactments, and so much more. For a 10% discount, mention SICW number 7 when you place your order. It's blackbearhaversack.com for top quality at reduced prices.
From the World Series champion Tigers in 45 to the Gateway Grizzlies to the 03 State Tournament Belleville East Lancers, a tradition in baseball and an even longer tradition in fine furniture and service. Miller Furniture, 1004 East Main in Belleville.
From St. Charles, Missouri, weighing in at 280 pounds, he is the former classic champion, Ron Powers. Yeah! And his partner from Indianapolis, Indiana, weighing 225 pounds, Flash Flanagan.
Well, I really don't have to tell you too much more than the ring announcer just told you. Because let's face it, this is a main event match. No question about it. You have two former classic wrestling champions in there, and you know the feud, the trouble that's been between Ricky Cruz and Ron Powers for a couple of years. Then you have Flash Flanagan in the ring, and then you have Chris Hargis in the ring, and they've had their battles together. Everybody has a lot to gain and much to lose in this tag team action. Flash Flanagan and Ron Powers against Chris Hargis and Ricky Cruz. Everybody wants a crack at the classic wrestling title. It's that simple. They want to knock Iron Man Ken Casa off the throne. They want to ride on top. They want to be number one. They want to be the man. Well, first you got to get through this thing. Let's see what's going to happen. Referee Jim Harris knows there's a little bit of tension in the air at the jam-packed East Carondelet Community Center building. Cruz and Hargis have a unique way to discover who's going to go into the ring first, and decides that Chris Hargis wins. A little encouragement from Ricky Cruz to Chris Hargis. And Flanagan jumps Hargis from behind very quickly. Side headlock on Chris Hargis. Off the ropes goes Flash Flanagan. Flying tackle by Flanagan. Whoop! Hargis trips Flanagan. And Flanagan landed right on his mouth. And now it's Hargis wailing away on Flash Flanagan. Flanagan, who hasn't made any friends here in SICW as he's been recording win after win, except for one that he lost to Chris Hargis on a count out of the ring. Hip toss by Hargis on Flanagan. Hargis ties up the arm of Flash Flanagan. Flanagan is one tough, smart cookie. And when Hargis can stay with him, I think that tells you everything you need to know about how Chris Hargis is developing. Ricky Cruz goes after Flash Flanagan, knocks him back into the corner. They had a Wild and Woolly tag, a Wild and Woolly title match up at the casino, the Argosy Casino in Alton, back in May. It looked like Flash Flanagan had pinned Ricky Cruz and won the title, but then it turned out the referee discovered that Flanagan had used a brass knucks to knock down Ricky Cruz, and he disqualified Flash Flanagan. Flanagan goes over to tag Ron Powers. He says, come on in the ring and look at that. Ron Powers says, what are you tagging me for? Flanagan says, you get in there. I had a rough time. I need to regather my wits. Cruz has something to say to Flanagan. Flanagan just turns his back on Cruz. Powers, Cruz, this means trouble. This means explosion, kick to the stomach. Elbow to the top of the head by Powers on Cruz. Big clothesline takes Ricky Cruz to the mat. Powers in command on Ricky Cruz, and he pounds on Ricky Cruz in that corner. Powers banging away on Cruz. Arm whip into the corner. Powers charges in and misses. Catches it right in the chest, knocks the wind out. And here comes Ricky Cruz up on the top rope, pounding on the face of Ron Powers. Powers dumps Cruz away, tried to suplex him, didn't work. And then a clothesline by Ricky Cruz on Ron Powers. Hey, this is the type of action you're going to be seeing when SICW hits the road this fall. Lots of action coming up. Let me mention a couple of dates that are really important, especially the one on September the 12th in Hillsdale, Missouri. 12 noon, outside in Hillsdale, Missouri, the Hillsdale Police Department and elected officials sponsor this back-to-school date, wrestling outside, wrestling under the sun. September 12th at noon in Hillsdale, Missouri. The police department's done this 3 years in a row now. It's something the community really enjoys. Everybody comes to see it and they have a great time with the action. That's not all. October 12th, SICW is going to be in Belleville at the Scottish Rites. That's right, a new building, a new venue. The Scottish Rites in Belleville on Frank Scott Parkway West, right by 161, right by the West End Post Office. October the 12th in Belleville, Fairmont City coming up, plus the regular action at East Carondelet. You'll see all the stars. You're going to see the Flash Flanagans, the Ron Powers, the Chris Hargises, the Ricky Cruz, the Dave Vaughns, the Iron Man Ken Cossett, all of them. Jake Durden's, Big Texan, Gary Jackson, all of them. Oh, Flash Flanagan lured Chris Hargis into a kick to the stomach. And then Hargis, tries to bounce the head of Hargis off the top rope, but Hargis blocks Flanagan's move, and now Hargis lashes out at Flash Flanagan. Hargis, whip reversed. Hargis hits the corner. Flanagan misses the elbows, but Ron Power steps in, and he didn't miss at all with that big clothesline to the forehead of Chris Hargis. We talked about how much some of these guys didn't like each other. Remember when the arm wrestling contest came up between Powers and Chris Hargis? Powers is a new way to strangle Chris Hargis. His boot right across the throat. Jim Harris says, I've seen that before, Ron Powers. You get off that man's throat. You let him breathe. Jim Harris balls out Ron Powers. Powers, his style's never going to change. He's tough. He's rough. Whatever it takes. He'll hurt somebody to win. If you cheer him, that's great. If you boo him, that's great. That's not his problem. His idea is winning. Once he said all he worries about is God, family, and the title. So you know he wants another crack at that classic wrestling championship. And if it means pinning Chris Hargis or Ricky Cruz right here to get a shot at Iron Man Ken Costa, that'd make Ron Powers very, very happy. And let me tell you something. If it was Powers and Flash Flanagan, and they were the two who had to decide between them who was going to get a title shot, that partnership would probably go down the drain pretty quick. Elbow drop by Powers on Hargis. Tag was made to Flash Flanagan, and Flash is in there putting the boots to Chris Hargis. Look at Flash Flanagan stomping on Chris Hargis. Flanagan picks Hargis up. Where is he going with Hargis? Trying to fight back, but he's a little battered at the moment. Knee lift by Flash Flanagan. Off the ropes comes Hargis. Sunset flip. Flanagan trying to keep his balance. Couldn't do it. Count of one, two, and Flanagan got away. Powers getting ready to come in there and break it up. Kick to the stomach by Flanagan on Hargis. Body slam by Flanagan. He yells something at Ricky Cruz, baiting Ricky Cruz. And then he tells the referee, look what Cruz is doing. Well, I don't think Ricky Cruz did anything. Oh, now Flanagan says, come on in that ring. Let me see you take a shot at me. And now the referees all engaged with Ricky Cruz while Ron Powers and Flash Flanagan double-team Chris Hargis. Two pros. They've been around that block before. They know the game. It ain't their first rodeo, as they say. Ron Powers pulling Hargis to the ropes. Oh, look out. Setting that leg up. This could be some trouble here. Powers yanking the legs back, snapping that groin muscle. And then Powers goes over, slaps Ricky Cruz. And once more, Jim Harris has to go back and chase Cruz out. Flanagan comes in the ring without a tag. And Flanagan stomping on Chris Hargis. No tag was ever made. Abdominal stretch. The abdominal stretch by Flash Flanagan on Chris Hargis. Flanagan pulling back with that abdominal stretch on Hargis. Is that a tag? I don't know. That's not a... Wait a minute. That's what Flanagan wants. He wants some help putting extra pressure on that abdominal stretch. And Powers says, no, no. I'm coughing. Yeah, right. Ron Powers has an answer for everything. Ooh, look where that elbow is being driven into that low rib. And now what's Powers doing? He's something behind. He's helping Flanagan get some extra pressure again. That's good, says Ron Powers. I'm glad you're watching. And once more, he helps Flash Flanagan get some pressure on that abdominal stretch. And the referee is going to make Flash Flanagan break the abdominal stretch. Ron Powers says, I was just shaking his hands, congratulating him. Okay. I don't think Jim Harris is buying anything. We talk about these wrestlers having been around the block. Well, Jim Harris has been around that block, too. He's seen some of the stuff that the tough guys will pull when there's a lot at stake. And there's a lot at stake in this tag team match. Powers and Flanagan, Hargis and Cruz. Flanagan moving behind. Hargis was going for an atomic knee drop, but Hargis spun away beautifully. Tag made to Ricky Cruz, and the Farmer Classic champions in after Flash Flanagan. Flanagan taking his lumps from Ricky Cruz. Kick to the stomach, kick to the side. Here comes Powers. He gets a boot to boot, and then a kick right to the mouth of Flash Flanagan. Powers pitches Cruz right through the ropes. He saw a chance, and he took advantage of it. Look out. Hargis comes off the second rope across Flash Flanagan. Is that a try for a pin? I don't think Hargis is a legal man. It doesn't really matter because there's Ron Powers to break it up as he's coming off the second rope with an elbow to the neck of Chris Hargis. Things breaking down, getting a little rough and tumble here. Here comes Cruz in to break it up. Who's legal in here? Let's see. I think it should be Cruz and Flanagan, but it looks to me like it's going to be Cruz and Powers in the ring. Oh, the super kick. The super kick by Ricky Cruz. I don't think he got all of it on Ron Powers, but he got enough to put Powers down. Flanagan after Cruz now. And both men go tumbling over the top as that flying clothesline by Cruz hits Flanagan. They both went over the top rope. And now it's Powers and Hargis in the ring. Jim Harris trying to keep order, trying to figure out who belongs in here. Hargis has Powers in trouble. Hey, there's Travis Cook outside. Travis Cook, grab Chris Hargis, Travis Cook, and Ken Costa standing at ringside with that title belt, just gloating, just really scouting to see what's going on. And they've gotten themselves somehow involved in this match by stopping Chris Hargis as he went after Ron Powers. Travis Cook says, hey, we're just out here watching. The innocent Travis Cook. And now Ken Costa, the Iron Man, starts beating on Chris Hargis. And there's Dave Vaughn, Mr. Unpredictable. He's on top of Hargis. The entire Travis Cook organization beating on Chris Hargis. The referee calling for disqualification. Here comes Cruz out with the kendo stick that belongs to Flanagan. Well, that got a little crazy at the end. End result, I'm pretty sure, is that the winner's by disqualification. Yes, that's what the ring announcer is saying right now. That's what Drew's telling everybody. There's been a disqualification against Powers and Flanagan because of what Travis Cook and his guys did. The winners are Ricky Cruz and Chris Hargis. But wait a minute, now Flanagan and Powers are in it. Flanagan's blaming Powers for the disqualification. What are you doing, says Flanagan. You got us disqualified. Powers is saying, wait a minute, buddy. You got us disqualified. Powers starts to walk away. And Ricky Cruz is there and he drop kicks Flanagan into Powers. Oh, Ricky Cruz always thinking, Cruz and Hargis, the winners.
The sensational new book by Larry Matisick is on sale now. The 50 Greatest Professional Wrestlers of All Time, The Definitive Shoot. Who was the best and why? Who's not on the list and why not? It's a fun read with tales of the greatest and those who were close. Get the inside stories about pro wrestling. Remember Larry's other books, Wrestling at the Chase, Brody, and Drawing Heat the Hard Way, are available too. And get the hot bestseller now, The 50 Greatest Professional Wrestlers of All Time. This is the one that every wrestling fan needs.
For the best deal on pre-owned cars and trucks, check out King Auto Sales in Cahokia, Illinois. Buy here, pay here. It doesn't get easier than that. Easy terms and financing on the spot for the best deals on all makes and models of pre-owned cars and trucks. You can't beat King Auto Sales, 2915 Camp Jackson Road, Cahokia, Illinois. That's King Auto Sales in Cahokia, where the customer comes first. Phone 337-7050.
Let Custom Truck Upholstery give your vehicle a facelift. Visit us on 707 North 20th Street in East St. Louis, Illinois. Custom Truck Upholstery merges old-world craftsmanship and attention to detail with the latest in modern technology to make your car, truck, boat, or motorcycle look like new. Call Custom Truck Upholstery at 618-875-9850.
Hey, I've got a couple kids here.
The word Donnybrook is used fairly often in professional wrestling. Well, Donnybrook pretty well describes our classic moment from October 28th, 1979, when two of my best friends in the business tangled, Kevin Von Erich and Dick Murdoch.
Kevin pulling back, stretching out the arm, stretching the back. Kevin with the abdominal stretch. Murdoch trying to pull the hand off the neck, grabs the hair, and manages to break up the abdominal stretch, but Kevin stays on Murdoch. Could roll him into a pin position, but not there. They're right in the ropes. Oh, Kevin Von Erich, like lightning. Like lightning. Kevin Von Erich had that abdominal stretch on Murdoch right in the middle of the ring. And now Murdoch takes a slow walk on the floor. He has a 20 count, and it would not be surprising to see Murdoch use a good 17 or 18 of that 20. Dick Murdoch taking full advantage of that count. Murdoch complaining because Kevin Von Erich's so close. He crawls cautiously through those ropes. Dick Murdoch. Tumultuous, turbulent, controversial, they all fit for Dick Murdoch. Knee lift to the stomach by Murdoch, and then a hard pop to the back by Murdoch. Kevin fights back. Hard uppercut by Murdoch knocks Von Erich to the corner. Another uppercut by Dick Murdoch, and Tangaro is incensed with Murdoch.
10 minutes have expired, 10 minutes left.
10 minutes have passed, there are 10 minutes remaining. Murdoch going for the suplexes, Texas Brainbuster as he calls it. The suplex, the Brainbuster, whatever you want to call it. There it is, the suplex by Dick Murdoch. This could, oh no, hey! Kevin survived the Texas Brainbuster of Murdoch. He kicked Murdoch off, and he didn't even wait till the count of two. Murdoch with an elbow to the neck of Kevin Von Erich. Oh, going for the pile driver. Going for the pile, oh, hey, Kevin blocked it. Kevin blocked it. Beautiful use of balance by Kevin Von Erich, and then he flipped Murdoch over the top. A kick to the head by Kevin Von Erich. Kevin with a punch right to the top of Murdoch's head. Drop kick by Kevin Von Erich. Murdoch seems shaken. I think he was stunned more than anything that his suplex, his Texas Brainbuster, did not do the job. Kevin hits the ropes. Giant splash. Oh, no. Right into the upraised knees of Murdoch. Right into those upraised knees. Kevin landing full force with his stomach across those knees. That could be the break Murdoch wanted. This could be it. Kevin Von Erich's giant splash backfiring. Murdoch stomping on the jaw of Kevin Von Erich. Kevin gasping, trying to get wind. Murdoch moving behind Kevin Von Erich, goes for the atomic knee drop. Kevin blocked it. Kevin stiffened the leg. He has a claw. Kevin has a claw. The Iron Claw on Dick Murdoch. Kevin Von Erich blocked the atomic knee drop. Kevin with the claw on Murdoch. Murdoch trying to pull the hand off. Trying to pull the claw away. He can't do it. Murdoch trying to pull that claw off of his forehead. He can't do it. Kevin Von Erich with the Iron Claw on Dick Murdoch. Kevin surviving the giant splash backfire, surviving the Texas Brainbuster. Now it's Kevin with the claw on Murdoch. Murdoch beginning to sag down to the mat. Murdoch down, the shoulders down. The referee counts one, counts two. Murdoch gets that shoulder up. Murdoch, in desperation, managed to lift that shoulder. Murdoch to the ropes. Oh, Murdoch tangled up with Kevin Von Erich. Kevin went sailing over the top rope, 10 foot high above the concrete floor. Kevin with a punch to Murdoch's stomach. Murdoch, even groggy in pain, he's looking around, he's dazed, he's looking for Kevin, finds him. Murdoch slams Kevin's head into the top turnbuckle. Murdoch, a bit desperate right now, I think. He grabs one of the microphone cables. Murdoch with a microphone cable, going after Kevin Von Erich. Murdoch with that microphone cable around the neck of Von Erich. Von Erich clamps on the claw again. Von Erich clamps on the claw again. Murdoch turns loose of the cable as the claw takes some more of its toll on Dick Murdoch. Kevin Von Erich crawling over those ropes to get into the ring on top of Murdoch. The claw, the Iron Claw, puts Murdoch down. Can Kevin keep him there, though? Murdoch will never give up. I'll guarantee you that. Murdoch will never quit. But if he's unconscious, he'll have no choice. Kevin Von Erich with the claw. The crowd standing, screaming. Here comes Bulldog Brown. Bulldog Brown, who was Murdoch's partner last week, came running into the ring. He attacks Kevin Von Erich, the referee calling for the bell. Brown all over Kevin Von Erich. It was obviously, it was a cinch at the Iron Claw. Here comes Gadiski. Here comes Gene Gadiski. Gadiski after Brown. Joe Tangero calling for some help. We have a riot on our hands. Gadiski and Brown. Von Erich and Murdoch. Brown pitched to the ropes. Gadiski nails him with a chop to the throat. Gadiski coming to help Kevin Von Erich against Murdoch. Tangero almost powerless to break up this brawl. Here comes Ron McFarlane to try and help restore order. Here comes Rock Hunter, who's on the card later today. We are having a brawl. Referee Lee Warren trying to pull Von Erich. Murdoch, here comes George Wells. Here comes Bruce Reed. Bulldog Brown has left, but Kaniski, Von Erich, Murdoch are all tangled up. Reed and Wells trying to calm down Von Erich. Von Erich gone berserk, so has Murdoch. Kaniski in the middle of it, trying to protect Kevin Von Erich. I'm sure the official verdict's going to be that there is a disqualification against Murdoch for interference by Brown. Look at Murdoch trying to get back at Kevin Von Erich. Kaniski trying to keep him from Von Erich. Von Erich simply gone wild. We have a convention in that ring trying to restore order. Kevin Von Erich and Dick Murdoch, tooth and nail, battling with each other. Murdoch and Von Erich finally separated. Wells, Reed, and Kaniski trying to calm Kevin Von Erich. Kevin trying to crawl between the legs of Kaniski and get at Murdoch. McFarlane and Hunter restraining Murdoch. And Kaniski has stomped on the hand of Murdoch to get his hand out of the hair of Kevin Von Erich. You know the guy who started all this left, Bulldog Bob Brown. He started this, Donnybrook. Kaniski ran him out of the ring, and now it's mainly a question of trying to separate Von Erich and Murdoch. Gene Kaniski, Bruce Reed, George Wells hanging on to Kevin Von Erich, McFarlane and Hunter pulling back Dick Murdoch. And I think we're going to try and get the official verdict from Mickey Garagiola now. I'm sure it's going to be a disqualification against Murdoch for interference by Brown. Here comes Murdoch again. He hits referee Warren. He's after Von Erich. He's after Von Erich once more. Murdoch's nose bleeding. Kevin with that claw up trying to get. Now Murdoch takes a punch at Wells. And George Wells squares off with Murdoch. Murdoch with a bloody nose. Another Donnybrook created mainly by Dick Murdoch and by Bulldog Bob Brown. I think we have order restored. Kevin trying to get back in, but Koniski pushing him back, saying, take it easy. Koniski keeping Kevin Von Erich from coming back after Dick Murdoch. Well, let's try and find out the official verdict on this match from Mickey.
Referee Joe Tangara disqualifies Murdoch for outside interference to winner Kevin Von Erich.
From the World Series champion Tigers in 45 to the Gateway Grizzlies to the 03 State Tournament Belleville East Lancers, a tradition in baseball and an even longer tradition in fine furniture and service. Miller Furniture, 1004 East Main in Belleville.
Farm Music and Fun, the place to party, is Pop's nightclub and concert venue in Sojay. From Bruno Mars or the first U.S. tour of Nickelback to Flogging Molly or the Insane Clown Posse, 30 years of memories pack Pop's concert venue with more made at every new show. And there's a party at Pop's nightclub every night, a melting pot of friends enjoy the best in dance, rock, pop, and top 40 music until 5:30 a.m. Plus add a full game room. Check out all the action at PopsRocks.com. Then and now, the place to party is Pop's in Sojay.
Baseball season is here and the Gateway Grizzlies are in action. Hardworking, hustling on every play, and lots of fun. What better way to spend an evening than at the gorgeous GCS Stadium watching the Grizzlies? Manager Phil Warren has a solid squad as they battle to make the playoffs. Special nights, plenty of promotions, and good baseball. Plus, GCS Stadium is easy to reach at Route 255 and Moosette Lane. To keep up with everything, go to GatewayGrizzlies.com. It's America's game, and the Grizzlies present baseball the way it should be. After today's turbulent tag team affair, plus the other results from a busy August schedule, promoter Herb Simmons had his hands full. Herb has to put together the lineup for the big SICW card Saturday, September 21st at the East Carondelet Community Center. Rest assured that Herb enjoys the job because, as you saw today, a lot of talented performers want an opportunity to show everyone how good they are. That definitely makes for plenty of excitement for the fans. What could be better than enjoying SICW Wrestling Explosion?
Take over, go back to the back and talk about this. Maybe you'll make the same mistake next time.
Really?